Hey everybody, welcome to this week's video. I want to quickly go over one component of your Facebook page that I think every business can benefit from, and that if not properly set up, you may not even know that it exists. So let's get that turned on and get people connecting with you quickly and easily. So let's get into it. So we're going to jump over here to the Facebook page. I'm going to use our page, the Get Quirked page, for this example. And so what we want to do is be logged in through the Business Manager. Of course, you can see Business Manager over here, logged in to Get Quirked. And what you're going to see up at the top is your navigation settings, or navigation items, and then we want to pop over to the right-hand side over here to settings. So when we pull that up, we're going to have tons of things to look at, but obviously, we just want to focus on the messaging aspect. Now, don't go here first, because a lot of people will and they won't be able to find the settings. What we want to do is be able to turn messaging on. And where we do that is in the General tab, which we're already on. It defaults to this. We want to go down the list to Messages. So if we just select that by clicking on it, you'll see that we are already set up to allow people to contact our page privately. We show the messaging button, and that does pull up that people can use Facebook Messenger and directly contact our page. And this can be super important for your business because a lot of people are on Facebook. They're on Facebook a lot. When they see your ad, when they see your post, they might want to interact with you very, very quickly. You can even use Facebook ads and have the Facebook Messenger as a destination for those ads. So you may be familiar with running ads to an external site, linking them to your website or to a landing page. Well, you can actually change that destination to the Facebook Messenger. So it literally pops up the chat window when they click the action button in an ad. So it's really important to have this turned on so that people can get in touch with you. That means that they're actually interested in buying what you have, or at least learning more about it. So it's a good point to connect with them on. So we want to make sure that that box is checked, which it is here. So now we're going to go over to the messaging panel, and I'm going to show you a couple of things that you might not notice once you set this thing up, unless you pop over to this tab. All right, so we're over in the messaging settings, and you can see here, we can jump to the two different sections. We're not going to do that. We're just going to go over it real quick. So the general settings, use the return key to send messages. Whatever. That's fine. Now, the response assistant is where things get really cool, because I'm sure many of you have heard of services like ManyChat and Chatmatic that you can set up what people call the Facebook bot, the messenger bot. And that's just predefined messages that when people send you a message, try to connect with your page, you send a reply, but not you. It's actually the bot. So it's an automatic reply that goes out, and you can actually do that from straight within Facebook. Now, it's a little limited. The other platforms like ManyChat and like Chatmatic, they allow you to do so much more with it. But for most people getting started with this, just the basic application is going to be what you want. So we want to make sure that that is turned on, and here is our message that we have right now. So let's go ahead and change that to something new. So you'll see when somebody contacts you, they give you this little preview, and it's just an animated thing that's pre-populated with your text. And it's really cool because you can add the personalization down here, which is what I did, adding the first person's name. So this is our message. Hey Matt, thanks so much for reaching out. We'll be in touch as soon as possible. If it's urgent, just give us a call. And that's something we like to have because we actually do get messages from this. We get action on our phone from it. People see this response and they give us a call. Sometimes that can be a backfire. Thankfully, we have our phone number routed through Skype. So it calls Skype first before it goes through our voice or our phones directly. And that is really cool because I don't get woken up at 3 a.m. with calls. So if we wanted to change this, you literally just select the box. You can select all the text and start from scratch and say, hey, and then we want to add the person's name. So we want to add personalization. Let's do person's first name, comma. Perfect. So now you can see that. Hey, Matt, thanks so much. We'd love to be in touch with you right now. we're all away from our desk. Give us some time and we'll get back with you as soon as possible. Cool, so we could save that. I'm gonna go back to our original message because that works well for us. And we'll just go ahead and save that. So the next thing is the response time. This is cool because Facebook actually tells users of your page, so people who visit your page, they'll tell them exactly how responsive you are. So if you're getting a lot of messages through your page, let's say you already have this function turned on, and it's a feature that people are interacting with, but you're not actually taking the time to respond to them. So you can see here, you need to respond to at least 75% of the messages within a day or less to show a response time on your page. That's what we showed you earlier when you were looking at the page and you see that we typically respond right away. So we can also add this in. So we can let customers know that we'll respond as soon as possible, keep our responsiveness rating up, basically. So this is that we'll get back to you soon because we're not here message. So we have that turned on because it's great. People get that if we're not at a device and we don't respond right away. They'll get that within a certain period of time. After they message, Facebook will like check to see if we have responded recently. If not, they'll send this message out. And then the messenger greeting. So this is one where people initiate the conversation with you and they don't have a previous conversation going. So they'll actually get this response first. So if, say, we're running an ad, and we're running an ad to Messenger as a destination, when that person prompts the window to open to initiate the conversation with us using Facebook Messenger, they will actually get this message already in place for them. If we wanted to, if we took appointments on Facebook, booking events, we could actually send people automatic reminders to book again, kind of that automation thing. So this whole tool is super powerful, and we really highly recommend you put it on for your Facebook page. If you like this video, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel so you stay up to date with all of our information. And again, I'm Matt from Get Quirked, and we'll see you next week.